Hurling is one of Ireland's national sports. It holds a special place in the hearts of Irish people. All-Ireland Final Day holds so many emotions for the players, the management and fans alike. I investigated just how popular hurling is in Scotland and compared it with another ancient Celtic pastime, shinty.
I would look upon the All-Ireland Final as, if you like, a universal gathering of Irish people.
It's the place to be on All-Ireland Final Day, on the field, wanting to give your best. That's what it's all about.
I went to Yoker to see Glasgow Mid Argyle take on Inverness in a National League shinty game. Let's see how they got on. With little or no knowledge of shinty, except for the mixed rules game in the autumn, it is great to see the level of commitment, physicality and skill on show here today. The GAA purist believes it is the ground hurling skills in shinty that have diminished over the years, and they believe that's what is needed to improve the game for the future. With the similarities between shinty and hurling, it is easy to see why a mixed rules game was established. I was talking to George Shea, former Scotland manager. A stumbling block for shinty at club level is the amount of travel involved, something that only comes into contention in inter-county hurling.
Most players that play for us probably live within 30-40 miles of here. A lot of the players have actually travelled from far away to come to Glasgow for jobs and the like. So our team is probably, I'd say, two-thirds Glaswegians and a third guys who come to the city. First half was pretty scrappy. It was probably no clear team to win in the first half, to be fair. The second half, I think their fitness told, and the fact we kept a better shape in the second half, I think we were worthy victors. From the GAA's point of view, and particularly Liam O'Neill, he was looking at the shinty hurling in that they could promote their ground skills. Their ground skills could get a bit better than playing against us, whereas we had to up our fitness level and up our speed of thought and play when we were playing the hurler, so it was a benefit for both.
With hurling and shinty being so similar, Irish immigrants can adapt to playing shinty quite quickly.
Yeah, I mean, we've had one or two Irish guys over the years. I mean, at the moment, we've got Brian Slattery from Galway. He's currently injured, but he's due back in the next week or so. Now, he's a fantastic player. You can see his hurling skills coming to the fore when he's playing here. Great hand-eye coordination, great with the ball in the air, and a very skillful player on the ground as well. So, I mean, if he ever goes back home, he'll be some ground hurler, that's for sure.
I visited Cheerconnell GAA Club in Glasgow to help out at an underage hurling training session and see how the kids felt about both hurling and shinty.
My friend suggested it to me and I just loved it when I started.
I'm Callum, I'm 14 and we done it in my primary, like just for a day, and I liked it, so I looked for a club.
Depends if you like rough sports, really. Nah, 10 out of 10 is good.
I came up here expecting all of the kids playing to have a straightforward Irish connection. Surprisingly, every child that was here, from the ages of under 8s to under 16s, had no straightforward connection. They were Scottish kids born and bred, but each of them had learned how to pick up the sport through school, and it was great to see the community involvement. Each of the players played within their own level, training beforehand, and then went on to play a match. Boys and girls played together, which was great to see. And it was great to know that the Cheerconnell GAA Club had evolved over the years, going down as far as Birmingham to play teams from across the country in a tournament of hurling. With hurling and shinty sharing a common history and skill set, it is difficult to understand the difference in popularity. However, shinty is on the rise, and with the help of media coverage and schools, shinty could see a rise in popularity across Scotland in the very near future.
The composite rules game between Ireland and Scotland in the autumn can also play a huge role in the increasing popularity of shinty all over Scotland.